Hey, what's up guys? In this video, goodbye Mark 25. I know. I recently sold my Mark 25 to an individual, and if you haven't noticed already, this is actually a voiceover video. I recorded this just prior to selling it, and after the deal was done, the buyer asked me not to disclose certain information, which I did in the original quote-unquote soundtrack. So I'm doing a voiceover out of respect to him, and because I wanted to show you this Mark 25 one last time and kind of talk about this. So first off the bat, you know, the SIG 226 is a phenomenal handgun. I will not deny that. I love the way it looks. I liked looking at it. I liked manipulating it safely, of course, and handling it. But I just didn't bring it to the range. You know, it kind of got left behind in the safe every time I went to the range for whatever reason. And this is probably more personal preference and some training issues maybe. You know, again, I liked looking at it. I used it in various videos as an example gun, but it started to become jewelry, you know, like gun jewelry. And I don't have guns as jewelry, but, you know, that might fit some 1911s. You know, some 1911s could be considered jewelry. But anyways, this SIG Mark 25 is, you know, made to be shot and used and abused. And I wasn't doing that. I just didn't have any feeling to take it out to the range for whatever reason. I just liked looking at it and stuff like that. So when I did go to the range, you know, I would leave this behind and grab my HK USP 45. I like this pistol a lot more than the Mark 25. I like the way it looks. I like the way it handles. I like shooting it. I shoot it well and so on. I really like shooting this gun right here over the Mark 25. And that is just a personal preference. I get a lot more enjoyment shooting the USP. The Glock Model 19, well, I shoot this a lot because it's a concealed carry weapon system. That's why I shoot it a lot. You know, throughout all these years of being in this stuff here, SIGs and me, I don't know. You know, I just shy away from SIGs a lot. And that this is all just a personal preference and training issues. Because if you look at this SIG pistol, I use a thumbs forward grip. But if you look at the grip right there, it has that little bit of a hump, and those controls are right all up there. So when I do use a thumbs forward grip, my thumbs interfere with that slide stop, and I have some issues with the slide not locking back on an empty mag. But that's a training issue, right? Other things would be, I don't know. It does shoot very well. It does shoot good when I did shoot it, which I didn't shoot it often at all. But I just didn't get that feeling like I get with the USP. You know, I guess it just doesn't pique my interest as much as what I'm trying to say. And I literally only maybe put, I think I put less than 300 rounds through this gun, which is not a lot. So it is pretty still practically brand new. Now, I did have a few issues with the pistol. I had 6 failure to feeds and 2 failure to extracts. And this wasn't all just with me. I had other shooters and a gunsmith check it out, and it happened to them. And I made this buyer, you know, understand that this happened. I kept repeating, and he got all pissed and said, "I heard you the first 4 times. I don't care about that. I just want the gun." And I said, "Okay," because, you know, when I sold an SR9C a while ago, I had an issue with that person, so I just want to put it out there. Fine. Anyways, those malfunctions happen on, we noticed it all happened on 115 grain Winchester white box. When we used the 124 grain plus P gold dots, the Ranger T 127 grain plus P plus, and the NATO 124 grain, we didn't see any issues. I didn't see any issues. It seemed to only happen with, you know, Winchester white box 115 grain. So just putting it out there, kind of interesting. But other than that, it is a phenomenal handgun. I guess it's just not for me, personal preference. So I want to get something that I'm going to get more use out of and more enjoyment out of. So I do plan to use these funds and some other funds that I received from previous gun sales earlier this year to get 2 different 1911s. So that's what I plan to do. So just stay tuned on that. Then we have going to have 2 1911s coming. But I guess to end this video, just want to show you this Mark 25 one last time. It is a good gun. Personal preference and some training issues. I guess it just wasn't for me. So there you go, guys. That's about it. So as always, stay safe and check 360 often. Later.